What is up, you guys? It's your girl Robin coming at you with another video. So I kind of wanted to come in here because there's been so much stuff going on this week. I'm 10 weeks out from the WBFF. But yes, that leads me into my 10 weeks out update and what's been going on this past week. So for starters, this week started off with my son, Brayden, going to kindergarten. It was his first day, so I have some pictures and a video of him getting off the bus that I would love to share with you guys. So here we go. My wish for you is that this life becomes home. Amazing. He had a blast. He couldn't stop talking about it. And the rest of this week, he's had so much fun. He comes home every day with, you know, something new to tell me. So I'm definitely a happy, proud mom. But it was very emotional sending him off on the first day of school. I told myself I wasn't gonna cry, and I did. I cried like a little baby, but you know what? It was a good cry. I was beyond grateful in that moment of how far we have come, me and him. I was beyond happy and excited for him. I was also nervous because, you know, as a mom, you think of every negative possible thing to go wrong, because you hear of all those horror stories out there and just hope that, you know, none of that stuff will ever happen to you or your family, friends, or especially your kids going off to the first day of kindergarten. But, you know, I made it through the day and we've been good so far this week. No complaints, but yeah, we will see how the rest of this year goes and my son being a little kindergartner. And next year, he'll be off to first grade. He's no longer my baby. Alright guys, so now I'm going to jump in to the next day after Brayden's first day of kindergarten. I had an appointment with Bethany to get a myofascia release massage therapy session with her. Let's just say that was an experience that I've never had before. I kind of wanted to go in a little depth of that day. I mean, I have some clips that I'm going to show you guys, but I also have some stuff I wanted to kind of get in and talk to you guys more about. When it came to that appointment with Bethany. Okay, so the myofascia release massage therapy is a very safe and effective hands-on technique that requires pressure using tools or their hands. She used tools and her hands, so she used like a metal scraper on me and some other pretty cool looking tools. They had like a lot of like round ends and stuff like that, and then she used her hands. She also used the, I think it was coconut oil or maybe like some type of lotion on me, so when she was, you know, doing the tools and stuff like that, it slid a little bit easier. I think that's why she used it. Don't quote me. But yeah, it basically helps restore motion into the muscle and alleviates any kind of soreness and pain that you may have. So I am somebody who loves deep tissue massages, but this is definitely not like that. It's definitely a lot deeper of a massage. I'm not gonna lie, it was not a relaxing appointment. So if you're wanting to go there thinking that you're gonna be there to relax and lay back and shut your eyes and possibly fall asleep, you have a rude awakening. It was very painful, and it did leave some bruises. I can show you a little video from when I just finished the appointment and got into the car, and I will go ahead and insert that now. So that was a clip from right after the appointment. So as you see there, the bruising and redness and stuff like that wasn't as bad as 3 hours later. So I'm gonna go ahead and insert a clip there from when I just finished my at the gym. So yeah, as you can see there, 3 hours later, there was definitely redness going on and bruising that was starting to really show. The next day, the bruises were more like the major areas were red, but then there was some areas where I did feel a lot more pain when she was doing it. That really started turning like blue and purple like that into an actual bruise, and then the rest of the leg kind of stayed red. So it is a very painful massage therapy session, whatever you want to call it. Do I know if it's worth it? I don't know yet, because I have to wait until I'm completely healed, and then I feel like that's when I'm going to see the best results. My thing is, you know, any kind of surgery or anytime you do anything, most of the time it's worse before it gets better. And what I mean by that is, like, for instance, breast augmentation, which I might do a video, on here as well about, but, you know, they looked worse at first when I first had them done, and then they've just progressively gotten better. So I feel like this might be the same concept. You're gonna bruise, you're gonna be sore, but as time progresses, you're going to see the results. So fingers crossed, and I'm super excited to see how I turn out, if there is any results. But I will definitely keep you guys updated on that. I do want to go ahead and talk a little bit about Bethany. She's the one who did the actual myofascia release massage on me. She was absolutely amazing. She was so knowledgeable with fitness and this whole experience for me. She gave me some good advice as well when it came to training. She told me I need to do more stretches, which I am not gonna lie, I've been slacking. I used to be so keen on doing stretching for workouts. I mean, I was stretching before working out, I was stretching in between my sets, I was stretching after my workouts, and then I just kind of stopped. You know, you just get in that groove and you just start slipping, I guess. So I definitely need to start, you know, being more mindful when it comes to that and starting to stretch a lot more, because, you know, it's going to help out a lot with my results, especially with my competition coming up. Bethany gave me some advice as well for when I'm doing my leg workouts, because she noticed that my right leg was definitely more dominant than my left, which, I mean, we have that dominant side and the non-dominant side, but what happens is when you're working out, that just means that my right leg is working a lot harder than my left leg. So when I'm doing, like, let's say leg extensions and stuff like that, that I'm leaning more on my right side, or I guess how she explained it to me, I don't know if I'm saying this correctly, it seems to be that, you know, my right side is doing more of the work to where my left side isn't getting that good of a workout in. So she said doing like one-legged extensions and stuff like that will help with that, because I'm working on one side at a time, so it's forcing that left leg to use all of its power to complete the workout. But yes, as I was saying, Bethany is absolutely amazing. She's such a friendly woman. She has a lot going for her, and I can't wait to see, you know, what's in store for her. She has so much going on. She owns a bakery. She's doing these massages. She also does her own training. And she's kind of opening up, I want to say, like a gym, and it's going to have so much stuff in there. So she was already kind of telling me a little bit of stuff that she's going to implement in her gym, and I'm just excited, and I hope we keep in touch. And if, you know, this whole experience with her does great, I'm sure I'll keep seeing her again and going back for these massages. But because I am so close to my competition being 10 weeks out, I don't know if we're gonna fit another one of these appointments in, just because of the bruising, and I don't want to have bruises when I go on stage, because that would not be hot or sexy or attractive, right? All right, guys, so enough with all of that and the massage and stuff like that. To wrap it up with that, like I said, Bethany was absolutely amazing. The appointment was in fact very painful, but oddly enough satisfying, because as I feel, you know, it's about trusting the process. So hopefully I see results from this. I already feel like I have, but we'll know once I heal and all this bruising goes down. But yeah, overall it was a great experience, and I'm kind of glad I did it. But yeah, like I said, enough with all of that. Let's lead into the next day. So I am doing everything in my power right now to try to cover up these bruises the best that I can. I went tanning, got a spray tan, then I went into Sephora and bought a couple of Kat Von D's concealers. Hopefully if I could blend those two together, it might be able to match and we might be able to cover this up. If not, I am bringing some black thigh highs. If we're able to use them, that might help covering up the bruises on my legs, but we shall see. But I feel like we'll figure it out. I'm doing everything in my power right now just to try to, you know, cover it up the most that I can. But yes, I will definitely not schedule that massage / appointment before a photo shoot ever again. Ever again? I will never do it. Nope. But yeah, so right now I am rushing to go home, try to use the makeup concealer stuff to cover this all up, and then it'll probably be time for me to go ahead and pick up my little one off the bus. Then I'll have to rush home, do my makeup and my hair, and then take him to the babysitter, and then I will head out for the photo shoot. I'm hoping I can get some content for you guys from the photo shoot, but we shall see, and I will check in with you guys later. All right, so as you guys can see, I did my hair, my makeup, I just dropped off the little ones, so now I am headed to the photo shoot. So we'll see how it goes. I'm sure we will have a blast. I think it's some kind of Christmas theme, something like that. So we should see how it turns out. I'm super excited. What is up? So we just finished up here at the photo shoot. We did a little Christmas theme. Mike Beach Photography right over there. We had fun. It was a fun little, don't laugh at me guys. You guys are laughing at me. No, but yeah, it was super fun. We were in this big, what is this, a warehouse type thing?
Red Space Events.
Red Space Events. It's pretty cool, pretty awesome. But we had fun, and I will check in with you guys later. Peace out. I completely messed up. So I didn't know that I was gonna bruise from, you know, the appointment with Bethany, but I don't know what happened with my schedule. I ended up scheduling that the day before I had a photo shoot. So the next day after the massage with Bethany, I had to do a photo shoot. So I had those bruises all over my legs. So your girl had to figure out how to cover these bruises up as good as possible. So I did contact Mike, who was the photographer, to let him know that I was so sorry. I also didn't know how severe these bruises would be. I told them, you know, I never make these mistakes when it comes to scheduling. I'm generally a person that's very on time and I plan my things out very well and I stick to it, but I don't know, I got my weeks mixed up and it was just bad placement on my behalf. So I did let Mike know in advance, hey, I may be bruised up, but I just didn't know how severe. So that next day I did send him a video, kind of what my legs were looking like, and he pretty much almost had to reschedule it, but because of the photo shoot that we were doing, he said that we don't really need to worry about it too much. But because I felt so bad, I was like, what can I do to fix the situation and fix these bruises, even if we don't even use my legs in these shoots, which we ended up doing. So I was running around that whole day. I had to get my workout in, I had to get my food prepped, my cardio, I had to be ready and showered, makeup, hair, pack my bag for, you know, because they wanted to see some of the outfits that I have to see if we could incorporate it in the photo shoot. So I had to have all that stuff together, and then I went out and went tanning, hoping that tanning would kind of help with the bruising. And then I got a spray tan. So I did that as well. The tan and spray tan did help for the most part. I rushed to the mall and I got the Kat Von D concealer. So I went into Sephora and got like two different concealers, and I kind of like mixed the two, and then I literally took one of the blending sponges and just tapped all over my leg, and I hid the bruises as much as I could, and for the most part, turned out pretty damn good. The only parts that still kind of showed through was the real like purple and blue areas, which I obviously didn't have all the stuff to do the color correcting for that, but hopefully he's able to photo shoot some of that out, or, you know, fix that out for me. If not, we may or may not use those photos. We shall see. Oh my God, guys, that photo shoot was absolutely amazing. Mike and his beautiful helper, she was absolutely amazing as well. She was helping with like the setup and helping fix my hair and so forth. She was absolutely amazing. I loved both of them. We had a blast. I was totally comfortable with working with both of them. The location was awesome. It was a warehouse with these cool lights that changed colors and so forth. So I will insert some sneak peeks. So yeah, those are some sneak peeks for you guys. I'm super excited to see the final results, edited results of these photos. I'm not sure when that will be done, but we shall see. I can't wait to post them. But yes, I had an absolute blast with them, and we may just shoot again coming soon. And that is a secret. You guys will just have to wait to see what kind of photo shoot that is. Let's just say my 10 weeks out to the WBFF was full of exciting things going on with my son going to school for the first time, doing the photo shoot, getting the myofascia release massage with Bethany. So yeah, there was just so much going on. And it was a good week. I am a happy girl, and I'm 10 weeks out, guys. 10 weeks out. It's crazy. Crazy. But we got this. I'm excited, and I can't wait to come back with more videos for you guys. God, I'm corny. But yes, I will be back with more videos for you guys, and I hope you guys are enjoying everything so far. Thank you for supporting me and following me with this journey to the WBFF. But yes, if you like this video, have any comments, any questions about anything that's going on this week, go ahead, leave a comment. But yeah, if you want to see more videos from me, go ahead and like the video, let YouTube know you like my content, subscribe to your girl, and hit the bell button so you are notified when I release another video series to the WBFF. Bye!